Deuteronomy 9:3a. Ve'yadata hayom ki Adonai Elohecha hu ha'over lefanecha esh ochla hu yashmidem ve'hu yakne'em lefanecha. Here we get the vav consecutive on the perfect. Here we have a call perfect 2ms of the root yada. And so we get something like, and you shall know today. And very often this gets taken as the inference. You shall therefore know today. So you're crossing over into this land, but you should know today. And what is it that you should know? That the Lord your God, he, that's a great word, he is the one who is crossing over before you. So here we have a call participle of the root avar. So we heard earlier, you are crossing over with atah. With atah, you are crossing over. Now it is who, he, that is crossing over before you, and this is what you should know. It's a fantastic way this is put together, that it's the Lord your God who is crossing over before you, and he's crossing over as a fire, a consuming one. Here's another call participle, this time of the root achal, and this is a feminine singular participle, but it's functioning here more like an adjective. So verbal adjectives are participles, and this is a fire, a consuming one, or a consuming fire, telling how the Lord your God is crossing over. In other words, he's going to be the one who does the fighting for them, and we get that further delineated. Who, or he will destroy them. This is a hifil. It's a hifil imperfect 3ms of the root shamad plus a 3mp suffix. He will destroy them, and he will humble them. Here's another hifil imperfect 3ms, this time of the root kana plus 3mp suffix, and he will humble them before you. The humble word here has to do with sometimes shriveling or crinkling even. So he's the one who is going to cause them to shrivel up before you. Humble is probably a better word, but this shouldn't be understood as humbling in the sense of wisdom. This is more of humbling in the sense of he's going to cause them to wilt before you.